Our university hospital is the largest healthcare provider in the southwest of Germany. We are covering the entire spectrum of radiology here in Freiburg. We were very fortunate to be one of the first users of the near-tomb alpha here in Europe. With the new system, we feel that the demand for advanced imaging has really been increased. There are new patient populations that will benefit from the technology, particularly in the cardiovascular field. And that is the reason why we expanded our fleet for the second system that we'll be installing this year.
The most impressive case was an 85-year-old male patient who was referred with a diagnosis of severe aortic stenosis, and he had a previous stent implantation in the right coronary artery. When we performed the calcium scoring CT scan, which is part of our pre-TAVR CT scanning protocol, we saw that we had extensive coronary sclerosis. The Egerton score was over 4,000. Yet, under normal conditions, this would be a patient where I would not resume the examination. But here we performed the quantum HD cardiac CT and were able not only to visualize the stented lumen, but also the coronary arteries with no artifact interference and exclude in-stent stenosis. So this was a fantastic case, and it was also rewarded as the best radiology image of 2023.
With near-tomb alpha, we have a really perfect method for quantifying calcification and for evaluating the amount of calcification. And it's much easier for us to grade calcified stenosis in low, intermediate, or high-grade stenosis. So you can avoid an interventional procedure in these patients. The near-tomb alpha gives us reliable information on the patient anatomy, and this really allows us to open up new pathways.
So to sum it up, why I like near-tomb alpha, my life and the life of my patients is a little bit more beautiful since I work with this tool.